there's going to be a lot of zipping around in parts of Chicago.
Yeah, that zipping around is going to happen on electric shared scooters. WGN's Amy Rutledge tells us about this pilot program that's already been tried in some other cities.
Yeah, lots of cities. And you will certainly find as many people who hate electric scooters as those who love them in the big cities where they've already rolled out. But many officials will tell you that's because of how they were rolled out, with very few restrictions and very little, if any, local input. So after months of debate, the city of Chicago has decided to give e-scooters a try, with several watchful eyes keeping tabs. Starting this Saturday, hundreds, possibly a few thousand scooters will be zipping around Chicago streets as the city launches a four-month scooter pilot program. In an effort to reduce carbon emissions, the city is giving permits to 10 different companies. Each will be allowed to operate 250 scooters within a 50-square-mile test zone west of the downtown area. From Halsted at the Chicago River to the east, to Irving Park on the north, Harlem Avenue and the city limits to the west, and the Chicago River to the south. One of the many requirements being placed on vendors, balancing the placement of scooters within the test zone. Two priority areas have been designated, where 25% of each company's scooters will be placed each morning.
It's very well accepted by the millennial, and different people who doesn't have the riding bicycle skill can hoop on the scooter pretty easily.
Candace Shea is CEO of Veal Ride, a Chicago-based scooter company taking part in the pilot. They already operate scooters in cities across the U.S. from California to Massachusetts. Most of the companies work the same way. Users locate a scooter on an app, pay a dollar to unlock it, and then 15 cents a minute thereafter. Scooters will run 15 miles an hour and must be parked legally upright wherever bikes can be parked.
In the city of Chicago, we require users to take a picture at the end of their trip. So if the scooter is not propped up properly, we'll keep charging the riders until the scooter is properly parked.
But that doesn't always happen. Cities across the country have had troubled rollouts of the electric scooters, people complaining of riders on the sidewalks, scooters blocking the right of ways.
This is probably not the safest way to ride a scooter.
Riding dangerously. These videos all from an Instagram page dedicated solely to scooters behaving badly. City officials say that won't happen here. Strict guidelines are being put in place to keep the program safe. The Chicago Department of Transportation says scooters are limited to the bike lanes and walked on sidewalks. Riders must be 18 and obey all traffic laws. Scooters will operate from 5 a.m. to 10 p.m. daily and be removed from the public way each night. Any improperly parked scooters must be corrected by the vendor within 2 hours. When the pilot ends in October, a decision on their long-term use in Chicago will be made based on data collected from the 10 vendors.
So helmets are being highly, highly recommended. Many of the companies even offering free helmets to frequent riders. You will not be able to ride the scooters outside the test zone. They will actually slow down and stop if you go past that line. The city could suspend any of the vendors who do not properly follow the terms of the pilot program. Also, all vendors are required to make scooters available to people with disabilities, people who do not own a smartphone, and a cash payment option will be available to those without credit or debit cards. So it remains to be seen how it's going to go.
Right.
4 months, a lot of data being collected, and then they'll make a long-term plan.
And it starts this weekend, right?
It starts on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.